God is good
all the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
Today is a very special day. I've never celebrated this feast in my entire life. And so today is, I'm making history by joining the Filipino community in celebrating this very special day. We also honor to have Father Jobi with us. And Father Jobi, I was telling him, you know, he lived in the Philippines for many years, and so he must have participated in a lot of these day celebrations, and therefore he has a lot of knowledge about this very special day. And I'm impressed by all the little babies that we have here today. You know, we have the baby Jesus also in the crib. Then we have all these little statues here. We have baby Jesus on the screen. And we have so many babies among ourselves here. So today, indeed, is the day for our babies. Not only the little ones, but even the big young men and women that are here, like the guy who is taking pictures of me right here.
It's a video, Father.
Oh, he's taking a video. And so today, my dear brothers and sisters, what we want to do today is to say thank you to God. We want to say thank you to God because God, in the beginning, is the one that created man and woman. And also, God gave a command, and therefore, to have families is a command from God. And therefore, we want to thank God for the gift of the families that are here today, the men, the women who are here, those who are married. We want to assure them of our prayers, because they responded to that call to be joined in holy matrimony, to become one. Because that is what they are. In matrimony, man and woman become one. But that marriage and matrimony is not enough until they are able to see the fruits of their union, of their love. And so every couple that is married is always hoping and praying and expecting at some point that God will bless them with a baby or with babies. And when they are not arrived, what a joy. When you look at that baby, look at that child and you say, that's me. Flesh of my flesh, bones of my bones. And that child, as your genes, as everything that you have contributed in a way that you don't even understand, because this is the mystery of God. And so to have all of us here today, mothers, fathers, children, all the small ones, the big ones, it must be a day of joy. We come to say thank you, God, for the gift of the family. We know today the family is under attack, especially in this country. I don't know about other countries. In my country, things are different. And I want to believe in the Philippines also, it's different. I've now been in this parish for the last 4 years. And one of the things I have noticed is that the Filipino people, they are very closely knitted families. You know, you can see that they have that family thing about them, the belongingness. I belong to this family, I am proud to belong to this family. The families are proud to identify as families. There's nothing to be ashamed of when you say, this is my wife, this is my husband, these are my kids. You take pride in that. And that is what we are supposed to do, is to take pride in our families. Because our family is the nuclear of the society, the larger society, the human society. And to see that in the Filipino community, I'm very impressed. I think that the kids that go to this church, the young people that go to this church, the Filipino kids, they give a good example of the kind of life they have received, the examples they have received from their parents. You can see their discipline, their manner, their respect. You know, every time I meet them, I forget that they say, hey, bless me, Father, you know. I rush to hug them, because where I come from, we hug. But you see the Filipino people, they have taught their kids the importance of that blessing. Because we only need blessing, especially the young people. If they are to mature and become responsible Christian citizens of this world, they need to have that respect of their elders. And I see it all the time. I don't have to go very far. I look at this young man here, young Paul, his brother Tony and their sister, who is in the choir. And there I see, this is a typical Filipino family. The kind of a family you want to have, the family you take pride in saying, this is my son, this is my daughter. Because the family is where we learn to learn. It is the first school where we learn everything that makes us the people we become. So when you see a good person, remember they came from a good family. It didn't just happen. It is work that has been done by the parents. It takes a lot of patience, endurance, and hope. And also it takes a lot of directions, taking directions, receiving correction, receiving discipline to become the people that we become. It's a lot of work. It don't just happen. And so I want to thank the families that are here today. And today, as I said in the beginning, we want to bring our families to God. We want to lead the young people to God. Yes, they came from God. They are gifted from God. We also want to say, God, we thank you. Because that's what we saw also in Jesus. He came from God, became human, lived in a human family. And when you think of that family, they were very poor people. They didn't even have a bicycle. Can you imagine? They had to walk. They had nothing. But the one thing they had is they were proud to be a family. Yes, they were poor. They never had much of what we have. They don't even have half of what we have today. But we call them the Holy Family, the family that pray together and stay together. It's very encouraging for us to have them as the role model of all the other families, because we look upon them, we look up to them to be our role models. So today we want to thank God for the gift of our families. We want to assure the young people that are here today that we, as their parents, as their elders, we are very proud of them. When we look at the example that they give us, we are not embarrassed, we are not ashamed of them, because they behave in a way that any parent would want their kids to behave. They are the best behaved kids. And they have a lot of potential. They are very talented. They have a lot of good things going on. And it's upon the parents to discover what are the powers and the talents and the potential that these young people bring. Because we can exploit that for their good. We can encourage them, we can support them, and help them to realize all the goals and all the things that they have in order to make their future bigger, better, and brighter. Because their success is our success. Their joy is our joy. And when they fail, we also feel like we have failed. We should never be afraid to invest in our young people. You know, just from my own experience, I know that most of the young people that go to this church, the Filipinos, they are also top of their classes. Some of them go to these magnet schools because they are very smart. And so we salute them because of the hard work and the support they get from their parents and the people that encourage them. We tell them, you have come to this country, and we call this the country of opportunities, the country where there are a lot of opportunities and things. Go for them. If you are here, go for the best. And at the same time, do not forget who you are. Do not forget where you came from. Do not forget the people you left back home. If God blesses you here, be a blessing also to the people you left back home. Let them also be proud to see we have a son, we have a daughter, we have someone that is in America that we are very proud of. Because yes, you try to be your best. You have a lot of people to support you. And above all, you have the baby Jesus. As young people, you can relate better to Jesus because yes, you have that connection with Jesus. And when you look at Jesus and realize his life was not easy. As human, he had to go through all that you go through. He had to get up in the morning. And I know many young people hate getting up in the morning. You know, we are trying to start the 5 o'clock mass because, oh, grandma, I don't want to get up this time. I want to sleep. Boy, wake up, it's time to go to church. Man, can I sleep a little more? You know, we know they need our prompting, they need our encouragement, they need our support to help them to do what they need to do. And therefore today, dear brothers and sisters, once again, let us pray for our young people. Let us also remember, there are so many young people that are struggling, even in this country and back home, who do not have opportunities that we have, that do not see any hope of a future, a better future. And they too are children of God. We must remember them. We must pray for them. And where we can, we support them. You know, I come from Kenya, and Kenya is a poor country, maybe even poorer than the Philippines. There are a lot of poor kids in Kenya. And some of them are very smart. Some of them will become Barack Obama of the next 10, 20 years. But they need someone to support them. They need someone to say, yes, you can. They need someone to help them to go through life, to go through their studies, to get where they need to get. And so we need to remember these kind of kids. Both in this country and in other countries, abused. We also need to remember them and to pray for them and to be there for them, to support them and to help them, rather than to exploit them. Because remember Jesus saying, whatever you do to the least of these ones, you're doing to me. Yes, they are a reflection of Christ himself as a baby. Remember when Christ was born, there was a king who tried to destroy him, Herod, because he did not want that boy to become a king. So there may be other Herods in our lives who do not want us to make it to the top. And they'll try to destroy you. They'll try to steal from you, take from you your innocence, your opportunities. But remember, you have God. You have the family, you have the community to help you to make it to the top. Like Mary and Joseph, parents must become the protectors and the providers. Like Jesus was taken to Egypt. Egypt, of course, is in Africa. Someone was asking me the other day, where is Egypt? I said, Egypt is in Africa. You know, they think Egypt hangs somewhere in the sky. It's in Africa. For those of you who may not know, you need to revise your geography. Egypt is in Africa, North Africa. So they had to go there in order to avoid this kid getting killed. Meaning parents must also be the protectors of their children. They must provide, they must also make sure that their kids are secure. And the kids must respect their parents and obey them. You know, sometimes we have problems with kids that don't listen. And they don't obey. And they think they're smarter than the parents sometimes. Of course, maybe in school they are smarter, but you know, parents are wise, you know. When you see your mom and dad, they are very smart. That's why they raised you to be a smart person. If you are smart, it's because you have smart parents. You know, so you must respect them because they have done everything they have done to make you the person you are. So today, without going too far, I just want to say thank you to you all, especially for bringing your kids to church. I have baptized so many of your babies, and I hope I continue to baptize them. Because even though they belong to you, they also belong to the church. Because you are part of the church. You are part of the family of God. And so in baptism, your children also become part of the church, part of the family of God. So we want to encourage you to bring your kids to church. Let them know there is God from the time they are little. You know, there's a little friend of mine in the back. Her name is Stacy. She's this little there. Very young. But she knows me now because she sees me all the time. She may not be able to pronounce my name because even some people here can't pronounce my name, you know. they can. They are good friends of mine. But Stacy, she knows this is Father. When she meets Father, she wants to say, Father, bless me. She don't know how to say it. But I know she's not great, because that is the way she's been raised by her parents. And so, once again, bring your kids to church. Let them grow in the church. This is where they belong. And I'm very proud that the Filipino people are very Catholic. Very Catholic. And therefore, they bring their kids to church and they grow up to become wonderful members of the church. We want them to get involved in all the various ministries of the church. As you know, this coming weekend, Saturday, we will be training people here for all the ministries. Archers, ministers of Holy Communion, lectures, music, everything. And so, we want them to be part of that. We want them to take pride in belonging to this church and the universal church. So today we pray that God will bless all the young people that are here today and those who could not be with us, wherever they are, that they may know just how much God loves them. May they find a consolation in seeing the baby Jesus, who was poor and yet was God, in knowing that your situation could change. Don't despair, don't give up. There's a possibility if you do what you're doing today and do your best, someday you might be the best. May God bless you. May God bless us all. May God bless all the people in the Philippines, especially those who suffered during the El Nino, the tornadoes that were there the other day, and those who have died, members of our families, the families that are here. We pray that they may also rest in peace. And may God bless us in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the